teach him how to stand. I don't follow no dreams. You see the light. You can believe all the hype. Religious from day to the night. You're paying the price. Tell him my time is now. I'm better than ready to fight. Into the struggle, the hustle, the pain. I see the smiles from the fake on their face. This is my time. Ain't no time to waste. The warrior's ready. They're screaming my name. Taking it all. Settle the score. No, I will not take a loss. Taking it all.
I have been destined to win. I thought I'll make it the end. Let it begin. Give you a scope through my lens. I do not follow no dreams. You see the light. You can believe all the hype. Relentless from day to the night. You're paying the price. Tell them my time is now. I'm better than ready to fight. Into the struggle, the hustle, the pain. I see the smiles from the fake on their face. This is my time. Ain't no time to waste. The warrior's ready. They're screaming my name. Taking it all.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4, and is for the Raw Women's Championship!
Oh boy, gentlemen, the goddess of WWE has arrived! Athletic background of gymnastics, kickboxing, track, even weightlifting. And now Alexa Bliss, one of the most meanest and dangerous superstars of any size. She's also highly intelligent, Zaxxon, and wouldn't appreciate you calling her the most meanest. Don't tell her it's redundant. I never get tired of being graced by the goddess's presence. One of the most popular competitors in the women's division. Guys, Liv Morgan just living out her dream here in WWE.
Yeah, Liv's career has just really taken off. Became this money in the bank and then successfully cashed in the contract to become SmackDown Women's Champion.
Introducing the challenger from Elmwood Park, New Jersey, Liv Morgan! And her opponent from Columbus, Ohio, she is the Raw Women's Champion, Alexa Bliss!
The Raw Women's Champion possibly taking one final look at her title.
I can honestly tell you there's only one question on these women's minds right now. Who will walk out of here the face of WWE's flagship women's division? I imagine they each have very different answers.
She heads out of the ring, but she needs to pay attention to the ref's count. That's what they call it, a hot shot.
A well-timed dodge.
A nice shot by Alexa Bliss.
Out of the blue, Bliss gets countered.
What's the biggest mistake a competitor might make when taking on Liv Morgan?
That would be underestimating her. Some people still see Liv as the perpetual underdog, but she's a competitor you should take very seriously. So don't go easy on her and press any advantage you can find inside the ring.
Reversal! What a counter!
Back and forth, looking for the advantage here.
Oh, what a DDT!
Wow. Oh, round and round we go.
Tilt-a-whirl head scissors.
Shot right to the kidney. Oh. And again.
Great win.
Recovered by the champ. Getting the shoulder up before two.
Impressive to not even allow a two count at this juncture.
Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
Vicious knee drop.
Bliss counters.
Great job refocusing to the works now.
And oh my God, what a...
Sent to the outside.
Gonna risk it all right here.
Thinking about it, gonna do it.
Just exhibiting their fearlessness.
Exhibiting guts and accuracy as well.
Oh, reversal catches Alexa. A sit-out mat slam.
As this rivalry has grown more and more intense, reason has gone right out the window.
That happens when a feud is allowed to fester like this one has.
Yeah, there's no telling what we might see tonight. There's just so much rage and resentment in the ring.
A showcase of skill from Liv Morgan. Alexa has to find herself an opening.
Oh, step up in Ziggy. Jumping complete shot.
The title's in jeopardy here.
I think the paradigm has shifted. This could be an opportunity.
Seeing an answer for every move attempted.
Stops the attack with a hit to the gut.
Quick exchange, reversing the reversal.
All right, she's back in, ready to go.
Dropping the arm.
STO! The challenger not looking good right now.
That was Bliss showing why she's always ready to pounce on you.
Alexa!
And she doesn't connect.
Nice buster!
Man, that was vicious.
have to say, I feel like we are just one move away from claiming a winner in this one.
One more move or one more misstep, either one can do it.
And responds with a counter of their own.
Forks the move by throwing an elbow into the midsection.
And one more reversal. Talk about evenly matched here.
Ooh, she just turned it around.
Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
Herself exposed here. Holding the shoulder hostage now. Shoulders down. 2 inches on the line. Barely kicks out. What does she have to do to put her away?
I'm asking myself the same question. I have no idea.
Ooh, what a forearm club. Liv holds her off. Ooh, walloped by a huge club.
Running close line.
Morgan and the WWE Universe exchanging their appreciation.
Alexa Bliss! DDT!
Looks like the champ is going to retain.
There's two! No, she kicks out, she kicks out!
The champion's shock is palpable. The champ will have to dig deeper now.
I'm not sure how Alexa was able to seal the deal after that. Looking for a high-risk move.
Alexa Bliss, twisted Bliss.
Another one bites the dust to the champ.
Two. Got it. And the champ adds to their legacy.
That had to be one of the matches of the year. Let's take another look at some of the action.
Your winner, and still the Raw Women's Champion, Alexa Bliss.
Perseverance getting the gritty victory tonight. The entire women's division was watching this one, and she is the one to watch, guys.
The official, the only club that matters.
More championships among the three than most of the locker room combined.
Looking for war.
considered an all-time great team, but now they've proven it beyond a shadow of a doubt.
Yeah, unifying the Raw and SmackDown tag titles, the longest tag title reign in WWE history, that is more than enough proof.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the WWE Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers at a combined weight of 505 pounds, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson, the OC. And their opponents at a combined weight 493 pounds. They are the WWE Tag Team Champions, Jimmy Uso and Jey Uso, the Bloodline.
Matchups like these are why I love tag team wrestling.
Jimmy and Jey ready to get this match going here. They've certainly made their mark on the WWE Tag Team Division.
It's no surprise, Cole. Their family legacy is deeply rooted in tag team action. The Usos proudly command the same respect that their father achieved in the Tag Team Division. And while they pay homage to their lineage, they've also made it clear they're doing things in their own way.
There's no questioning that with their uniquely wild aerial offense and their hard-hitting strikes, Jimmy and Jey have certainly cemented a legacy of their own.
Will we crown new tag team champions tonight? Given who's inside that ring right now, I wouldn't be surprised if we did.
Uso splash!
The communication between these two is evident by that move. Champ's got the pin to retain. Quick shoulder up.
Keeping a loss at bay for now.
Ooh, nasty shot to the throat.
Oh, God, that hurt.
What a hit from Gallows.
That was almost a knockout.
And Jey reverses. Carl gets jolted by the counter.
Well, maybe it's just me, but you can only be disrespected so many times like that before you start to develop a complex.
You get slapped a lot, Corey?
It's none of your business, Cole.
Jey showing his instincts.
Shoulder block with a corkscrew.
Boozled up. This is not.
Uh-oh.
I had that well scouted.
Double hit.
Shot. The challenger eating up some damage. Backbreaker. And he barely evades. Clearly no love lost between these two with a display like that. Sends him into the corner.
Uh-oh.
Face first in the turnbuckle.
Big double axe handle.
Vicious knee. Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless. Right in the face.
My God.
Took the worst of that on his face, and it looks like there's a cut, too.
Oh,
here's the pin. Title on the line.
No, he kicks out.
These men knew this this match is going to be hard fought.
Big forearm. Wow, the physicality on display there. Unbelievable. What a headbutt. Vicious. A bad place to be for the challenger.
Yeah, this is exactly why constant, frequent tags are so important in a match like this, to keep fresh.
The following slam. To the throat. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, oh, strongest flag.
Up into the fireman's carry.
And bang. Tagged into the action. Carefully measured knee drop. Jay puts a stop to that.
Supercut!
Oh, the knee takes a big hit.
Dodges the attack just a smidge quicker.
Setting up for something here. Oh, sent flying. The challenger eating up some damage.
Going right after the neck.
Neck breaker. Boy, European uppercut. Counter on Anderson Taser.
Defenses are sharp in this series of reversals.
Here we go. This is going to be nasty. Step powerbomb. Put into the corner now. Boom. He turns it around. Four. Smash.
Spybuster. Jay is in a very vulnerable position here.
Jeez, and Jay was opened up there.
We could have a new champion.
We just saw, I think this match is far from over.
Who knows what that kick out cost? The champ might be running on fumes.
I thought it was over. The WWE Universe thought it was over. But you gotta do a little more to finally finish this.
Here's a tag. Opponent off the ropes.
Double big back body drop.
Tag made. What do these two superstars have in store for their opponent?
Fantastic neckbreaker suplex combo.
That's gotta be it.
Two. Yes, they did it. New tag team champs.
Some superstars doing what they do best. Here are the highlights.
Here are your winners, Luke Gallows and Carl Anderson.
And they get the win, thanks in large part to Carl Anderson.
Really putting the sports in sports entertainment. This is a duo that really practiced their teamwork.
The following contest is a tag team Extreme Rules match and is for the WWE Women's Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers, Katana Chance and Kaden Carter. And boom! And their opponents, they are the WWE Women's Tag Team Champions, Tamina and Shayna Baszler.
The WWE Women's Tag titles are up for grabs here tonight. This is sure to be a momentous match.
Tag team champions at risk of losing their titles in this treacherous Extreme Rules match with Katana Chance and Kaden Carter. And across from them, they will be squaring off with Tamina and Shayna Baszler.
Extreme Rules is always a dangerous match for all participants, but probably none more than for the title holder.
You can only hope that the champions coming into this match fully aware of how fluid the situation is, how nothing is out of the realm of possibility. But even with that knowledge, this could very well be the champion's toughest title defense.
It's their opponent's legs. That's a great fall.
Oh, stomping away.
Overhand connects.
Everything is legal in an Extreme Rules match. What does a superstar have to do to a dip?
From the top.
Shoulders are down. Two for the title. Gets the shoulder up after one.
Clearly, she's still got a lot of fight left in her.
Off the ropes.
A slingshot into a cross body. What a move.
That's playing fast and loose with your own body.
That is weaponizing your body. That's what that was.
The champ now absorbing a little damage. And a well-executed move we just saw there.
Is attacking with malicious intent.
You gotta wonder if there's more animosity in this match than we previously thought. Kick from behind.
Ouch.
She heads out of the ring.
An interesting strategy.
Once she gets going with that kendo stick, this match could be over real fast.
But she turns it around. Kendo stick impact. Evading offense. And she's stunned in the corner. To the outside.
This could get
better. Oh, no champ. Oh, no. No possible setup for a submission maneuver.
And those kickouts are only going to get harder.
Uh-oh, it's locked in. The arm bar.
Oh, my goodness.
You gotta respect her continued effort to get out of this, to continue fighting, to survive.
Great counter by Baszler.
Yokes up their opponent.
Sidewalk slam delivered.
The challenger's looking shaken.
Bam!
agility like that, easier said than done, gentlemen.
Climbing to the top rope. Down to her. DDT.
Look out. She comes up empty.
Tamina gets out of harm's way.
Covered by the champ.
She kicks out in one.
Impressive to not even allow a two count at this juncture. Sequence of reversals here. Both superstars clearly studied game tape ahead of time.
Shot by Shayna Baszler.
Oh, she's able to use one good leg there.
Oh!
And oh my God, what a fall! And Tamina didn't see that coming.
See Chance's eyes taking aim.
Slips out of the way. Wheelbarrow rolls through, shoulders down.
And she fights it off, driven into the barricade. She's taking things to ringside.
Spades showing her power.
Yokosuka cutter to retain the title.
Oh, come on, ref, get some control.
Shot, Byron. At this juncture, you have to wonder if these superstars can keep up this pace.
They're certainly being taken into the deep waters now.
Is this ever going to end?
I hope not.
Turns it around. She catches Katana with a counter. Dangerous intentions in her mind right now.
A steel chair. She's taking this match into even more.
Champion into the corner. Maybe not.
Confused and more.
Oh, she takes to the sky
and lands with a thunderous crash. Oh my goodness.
Got it.
I guess that's
Alexander can cause some serious damage. God, what a match.
And this match will head back to the ring.
Running Hurricane Rana.
She's taking this outside. This one cannot be lost by count out. Katana perched up top.
She's climbing to the top turnbuckle.
Got it, and the tag titles change hands here tonight.
Let's take another look at what made that matchup so memorable.
Here are your winners, Katana Chance and Kaden Carter. And boom!
Making their case for one of the best teams around with that win.
The wrestling gods have truly blessed this union. I fully expect to see more showings like this going forward from this duo.
The following contest is a last man standing match. That is for the WWE Intercontinental Championship.
Here comes LA Knight, a man who brings the excitement level to the max. We'll be right back.
the Street Champions.
Brother of the Usos, but had a far different upbringing.
But Jimmy and Jay were getting their start in WWE. Solo was still getting into fights on the street. Time for the Enforcer to make the Bloodline proud.
Oh, I have no doubt he will do so.
Introducing the challenger from Hagerstown, Maryland, weighing in at 230 pounds, LA Knight. And his opponent from Las Vegas, Nevada, weighing in at 250 pounds, he is the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Solo Sikoa.
The Intercontinental Championship, one of the most prestigious titles in all of sports entertainment.
The Intercontinental Championship held by over a dozen WWE Hall of Famers, the likes of Stone Cold Steve Austin, Shawn Michaels, Bret Hart.
Well, that title symbolizes the workhorse of WWE.
It certainly has a history of being the largest stepping stone any individual can climb. Known to put superstars on the map. All facts that these men know very well.
I'd have to think that a no disqualification match favors the most heartless competitor in the ring.
Well, it's mostly true, but even the most rule-abiding superstars have risen to the occasion of a no disqualification match. When there are no rules, there's no wrong and right.
And that was offense with a hurtful purpose.
Vicious right forearm.
Between the eyes. Heel hook. Look at this. Oh, that's so painful.
It's hard to watch, too.
Foot to the gut. The champ getting put to the test here. Knight caught by surprise.
And both athletes showing that they have each other's number.
Oh, man, a little extra luster behind that kick.
Out and he has all the time he wants. Oh, God.
Watch out. They're coming towards the announce desk.
What the hell are you doing, Byron?
Oh, man.
Up and down. What a slam.
Answering back. Fist right on the temple. Uh-oh, clearing off the announce table.
Oh, this is about to go from bad to worse.
This is not going to be pretty.
I don't want to see this happen.
Put into place. Squaring off right by our announce table.
The solemn Solo Sikoa. He must be pumped.
A bear hug, squeezing the breath out of him.
Well, this isn't going to win the fall, but it's going to do a lot of damage.
Furiously trying to fight his way out of the bear hug.
do it. Yes.
Clothesline.
Dropkick. The effects of this match are showing on the champ.
And we're deep into this last man standing match now. Every blow makes it harder and harder to stay off the ground.
Absolute hatred boiling over in this one. This continues to be personal, not just professional.
You're right, Cole. Sure, either side would love to beat the other in competition, but this is more about beating them down physically and mentally. Anytime, any place. Damn the consequences.
Still climbing. We're up to seven now.
And it looks like they've still got something left in the tank.
What a shot.
I don't think Sokoa is aware of the danger that's coming. LA Dragon showing his opponent takes a ride on the gravy train.
Knight giving the WWE Universe the chance to really appreciate it. This is not good.
And he'll stand to break the count and keep this one going.
Samoa drop.
Incredible.
Fires back with a crucial elbow.
Oh, God. The champ teetering on the edge. This has just been an absolute massacre.
Oh, Sokoa.
Being given by either competitor. You have to believe this one's going to be decided by the smallest of margins.
He saw it coming, taking advantage. Ooh, what a slap.
Here we go,
taking the fight near our announce table.
I really hope we get these desks at a discount.
And this count will stop.
This is either grit, insanity, or a little bit of both.
He's outside the ring now.
Hope he's got a plan.
Oh, my! He eludes the contact. And that was a precisely measured attack. Just one right after the other. Can't be stopped. And he slides him back to the mat.
He's back on his feet. And ready to keep going, it looks like.
No surprise that what we're witnessing is trending.
Look at trending on social media. The motion in the arena is charting on the Richter scale.
Reversals, reversals, and more reversals.
It up.
The cockiness of LA Knight not even considering taking this seriously.
Three, four, five, six.
A count of seven. Is this really it?
Not over yet.
Bullseye with the drop kick.
Any more hits in that area could leave him dizzy.
LA Dodgers showing his opponent takes a ride on the gravy train.
Outside of the ring now.
What's the plan here?
He's getting up, but there's danger in front of him.
Taking this one back to the ring now.
Boom!
And a big boot.
Looks like LA Knight has no respect for his competition.
Three, four, five, six, and there's seven.
It's getting close.
Let's take another look at the incredible hardcore action.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the WWE International Championship.
Indie wrestling is here.
Quite the impressive young talent.
Successful her entire career from Australia to NXT, now ready to conquer WWE.
You know, it gives Indy Hartwell that advantage is her incredible strength. She almost always has the size advantage inside the ring.
Has already seen so much success in NXT and WWE.
Yeah, but Cole, Indy Hartwell is only getting better.
True ballsy entrance. Welcome to the bar, thank you.
Introducing the challenger from Oakland, California, Shotzi! And her opponent from Melbourne, Australia, she is the WWE International Champion, Indy Hartwell!
You win this title, you are a top name in this industry.
You'll have to forgive me for the lack of information on this title, but I have heard that it's highly coveted.
Well, my sources sent me a VHS tape of this title's greatest matches, and there were some all-time classics.
Really? Hey, can I borrow that tape?
Absolutely not, Saxon. I'd be doing a disservice to my sources.
Gonna step up in Zagari, right in the ear.
She's staying elusive.
Boom! A forearm smash. Oh, man, what a strike.
Reversal after reversal. These two are ready for each other.
Oh, it didn't go as planned there. Out of the ring, she has to mind the 10 count. At times, Shotzi's style can seem a bit haphazard. We've seen her devil may care demeanor haunt her from time to time. Corey, how can Shotzi shake those ghosts?
While it may seem like Shotzi just throws caution to the wind, she does know what she's doing, Cole. She knows when the risk is worth the reward, and that's what makes her such a dangerous opponent.
Ooh, brutal forearm. Challenger's a little worse for wear now. Chop block. Brilliant. Right to the back of the knee. One step ahead of Shotzi there. Carefully placed stomp to the arm.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious.
Stop in the arm.
Connects on the kick. Oh, stomping right onto the arm.
Shotzi with the retaliation.
Indy keeps it in bed.
Shoulder up.
This match continues on.
Oh my goodness. Back elbow smash. Nothing fancy.
Getting carried. Unsure what they're thinking. We've seen a lot of contentious rivalries here in WWE over the years, but this is really starting to go over the edge.
I'm sure they're not thinking about it right now, but
look at this. Is it enough, guys? Is it enough to get back in this match?
Wow.
So far, so good.
Lined him up. Boom. Knocked him down.
Ducks through.
Up and over.
Salida del Sol.
Two. Almost beat the champ.
That sucked all the air out of this place. It looked like a done deal.
How's that for count.
Hammerlock. Reverse DDT. Brutal fall.
Shotzi kindly requests that you never wake up.
The champ's eyes were glazed over.
Two. The champ isn't going down easy.
That was a matter of a fraction of a second.
But if we see one more devastating move again, this can be over soon.
No way.
Oh, God.
That was an absolutely haphazard, uncalculated risk.
And I have no doubt they're going to pay dearly for it.
I think we are witnessing a career-altering moment for these superstars, guys.
The spoils will only go to the victor, and I have a feeling we're close to finding out exactly who that would be.
Shotzi getting a thunderous reaction from those in attendance.
At this point, this is incredibly ill-advised. You're in the middle of a match.
She's calling for it.
Drawing dangerously close to a count out here. Here we go. Oh, God, that's a bad landing.
That was playing with fire and getting burned.
The decision to take such a risk at this juncture is questionable.
Reversal. Can she capitalize? Match, but apparently not. What a comeback! Indy Hartwell, strong impact.
I think the champ's got it.
Here is your winner, and still,
Judgment Day is here.
And the WWE Universe will feel their wrath.
Thing about the Judgment Day is that their main goal seems to be spreading fear throughout WWE.
Make no mistake, the Judgment Day are all about wins and championships, but the psychological warfare they wage will keep this group atop WWE.
Look at them. You can just feel the passing judgment on the entire WWE Universe.
And after the judgment comes the punishment.
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the World Tag Team Championship. Introducing the challengers at a combined weight of 439 pounds, Finn Balor and Damian Priest, the Judgment Day. And their opponents at a combined weight of 492 pounds. They are the World Tag Team Champions, Angelo Dawkins and Montez Ford, the Street Profits.
So that's what it's all about, the tag team titles. It's an instant party in the WWE Universe whenever the Street Profits are in action. Montez and Angelo have certainly set themselves apart with a tremendous amount of swagger and athleticism.
Yeah, Michael, it's that athletic prowess that has made the Street Profits Triple Crown Tag Team Champions. When they want the smoke, they get the smoke.
Yeah. Well, Byron, we'll see how badly they want the smoke here tonight.
As we all know, guys, Philadelphia fans are among the toughest to impress, but I'm willing to bet these superstars will have them on their feet all match long.
Power slam! Oh, right in there.
Oh!
Uh-oh! And he's able to fight Priest off. Right to the midsection.
Staved off that attack. Look at this, going counter for counter. Boom!
Nice clothesline. Forced out of the ring.
And off the tag is Finn Balor.
Balor has him in the drop zone.
Acquired and destroyed.
And he tosses it from the top. Oh, no, that can change the whole complexion of this match.
Dawkins avoids that one.
What a forearm. Those last hits rattled the champ.
And yeah, it's about time to heavily consider tagging in that partner. The Prince telling his opponent, come get you some.
Return fire from Dawkins.
Finn left unprotected.
Control on a suplex. Here's a pin for the title. The challenger wriggles out in one.
I can't believe the ref didn't get two here.
Oh, man.
Able to reverse. Back and forth from these competitors. Spinning kick to the gut.
Ooh, goes tumbling to the outside.
There's absolutely no regard for your opponent's safety when you toss them to the outside like that. Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
He knew that was coming.
Oh, low drop kick right on the patella.
Oh, my gosh! Ooh.
That just opened up Angelo Dawkins.
Knife edge chop echoing through the arena. He's got the answer for that one.
Just look into the eyes of these superstars. They're clearly out for blood in this match.
That's what this ferocious rivalry has come to. It's not just about winning or losing anymore. It's about destruction.
And they'll do whatever it takes to achieve that goal. Misses the mark. Well-placed punch, ugly, but effective response. These two having an answer for everything. Reversal after reversal, proving they did their homework.
I don't like the look in his eye here, folks.
From the top.
Oh, an inadvertent shot hits the referee. He made it. Tag made.
Ortiz Ford, so elusive.
A jumping DDT. The challenger's looking shaken.
Ridiculous standing shooting star.
Wow, look at that agility. For the championship! And the ref can't even start the count.
Still in it.
What a gutsy performance.
He's tagging out. For Priest. Oh my God, DDT! Standing shooting star press, incredible! The challenger forces a shoulder up.
What stamina. It's truly impressive to completely beat the count here.
He's been placed in the corner now. And Priest with the wherewithal to counter.
Oh, what a bump to the face!
The champ not looking great right now.
Yeah, they stuck it out through this match, but it wouldn't hurt to go for the tag soon here.
Deep, deep trouble here for Montez.
Damian veering his attention away from the match. Not the best idea. Priest has him lined up.
Popped right in the face.
Oh, my God. DDT!
Spiked him.
Kick in the face.
He gets out of the way.
Cross body.
Oh, ouch.
Counters that. And he's able to counter.
Retaliated with a head-turning clothesline.
And we just saw some serious offense. And he saw that coming from Montez.
Oh, catches a kick to the face.
Ooh.
And Taz was expecting that.
The champ has been taken to their limit.
I don't want to say he's done, but I can hear the fat lady warming up.
A bit of psychological warfare from Angelo Dawkins here. I'll tell you, this guy's no competitor here. He's looking to give in. It's going to take a lot to end this fight.
We are just seeing sheer perseverance. No.
Damian Priest would like to be your guy.
Heaven choke slam. We could have a new champion.
Drop kick to the knee.
Going way up high.
We're about to take a trip. Something hammer.
The title might change hands. Look at this. Just stop at this.
With the championship on the line.
What made that match so special?
Here are your winners and the new World Tag Team Champions, Damian Priest and Finn Balor.
Two great superstars that go great together, and that win is proof. Two minds working as one in the ring to create magic. It is a beautiful thing to witness, gentlemen.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the WWE European Championship.
Yeah, now we're talking. Never looked more focused, laser focused on the task at hand.
Tommaso Ciampa has proven he'll do anything to succeed in WWE, including being friends with The Miz.
Hey, The Miz just recognizes a fellow A-list superstar.
Introducing the challenger from Milwaukee, Wisconsin, weighing in at 201 pounds, Tommaso Ciampa. And his opponent from Amsterdam in the Netherlands, weighing in at 215 pounds, he is the WWE European Champion,
remember guys, this represents all of Europe.
One of the more unique titles in WWE history on the line here tonight, the European title.
You call it unique, Cole. I call it underrated. Some truly great talents have held that championship.
The German.
An unyielding showing of authority, no two ways about it. Great wherewithal from Ciampa. Oh my God, a DDT! Carefully measured.
Again?
Just dismantling their opponent. Able to reverse that one.
Great job refocusing to reverse that. Counter upon counter. Great minds thinking alike.
Tommaso Ciampa seems to draw from a nearly bottomless well of stamina. How can he use that to get the upper hand?
Well, unlike most superstars, Ciampa has the ability to drag a match out. In fact, the longer it goes on, the more he's favored to win. But Ciampa could also use that impressive stamina to pour on the gas and deliver high-paced offense that will overwhelm his opponent.
Crushing knee strike.
Just letting his opponent know who the real top guy is.
He knows how to avoid contact.
Put it down across the back.
The challenger not looking good right now. Look out!
That's finding any which way to topple the competition.
Hurling your own body like that is insane.
Two. Hits him with the counter.
Three.
Reversal on top of reversal. Catches the leg. Brought back into the ring from the floor now.
This has been building.
The champ's shoulders are down. He got the shoulder up in time.
You expect these pins to last much longer at this stage in the match.
What a barrage of stomps. A step ahead of Ciampa. Kick out after one from the champion.
Still gonna take a massive effort to keep him down.
Got it scouted. Look at this beautiful Northern Lights suplex.
Beginning of the end.
We are witnessing the beginning of the end.
Oh my gosh! The champ. Survived that
by the skin of their teeth, and don't expect the champ to start going easy on him now. Listen, that should have ended things. And look at his face at this point. You have to believe he's losing some faith in himself. You can see it in these superstars' faces. They're in serious pain at the moment.
A lot of punishment has been dished out, but no one is thinking about quitting.
You have to wonder how much more can Ciampa.
Left foot hospital, right foot graveyard. The title's going nowhere. Kiss your dream, and the champ retains. These gentlemen get after it. Here are the highlights.
Here is your winner, and still, WWE European Champion.
And that seemed like a pretty easy day at the office right there.
An absolute statement by the victor here tonight.
What
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from New York City, weighing in at 290 pounds, John Bradshaw Layfield, JBL.
One of the longest reigning champions of the Ruthless Aggression era.
Yeah, his personal wealth only matched by his wealth of wrestling knowledge inside the squared circle.
I'm surprised at this point, Saxton, that John hasn't paid you just to stay away.
Come on. Secretly, John loves me.
One of the best brawlers in WWE history.
Hey, Corey, you think JBL will pay the medical facility bills for his opposition tonight?
Representing the Brawling Brutes from Dublin, Ireland, weighing in at 267 pounds, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus!
Yeah, at the hands of the Brutes, they have been a thorn in the side of the otherwise dominant bloodline.
Yeah, after the Brawling Brutes competed in their first World Games match, I think the entire WWE Universe developed a newfound respect for the Brutes.
Ridge, the Fridge, Sheamus, and Butch about to do what they do best.
We are about to see the fight of a lifetime.
The Brawling Brute Sheamus in action here. At times it seemed that Sheamus is more focused on physically punishing his opponents than getting the win.
Now that might be true sometimes, Cole. There's no denying the spit and vinegar that flows through Sheamus's veins, but we've all seen what he'll do to win when he's focused on it.
That certainly does make Sheamus an unpredictable opponent and a difficult task to handle in a fight.
Yeah, but he's facing a bona fide Hall of Famer. JBL is a true blend of styles and old-school aggression with a modern analytical mind that ultimately took him to the top of the heap.
Few superstars have done as much to earn the name Hall of Famer as John Bradshaw Layfield. This guy was clotheslining people across three decades, racking up wins and making a killing in the finance world to boot.
Snapmare takedown.
Drinking across the face.
Corey, how do you think Sheamus's particular brand of smash mouth offense is going to fare for him here?
I've said it before and I'll say it again. No reason to fix what ain't broken. And right now, all Sheamus needs to focus on is breaking the competition. He switches it back around.
That'll cost some teeth.
And no dividends being paid out to JBL there.
Yeah, there is no doubt that Sheamus's heart is pumping vinegar now.
He turns it around on JBL.
Ooh, stiff kick. Showing out their deadlifting prowess and just tossing their opponent like they're nothing.
I'll just leave it at this. Nobody comes into a match hoping to get chucked around like that.
Close to over.
Can they go on the attack?
He skirts around it.
Fallaway slam!
It couldn't have felt good being chucked around like that.
From way up. Oh, no! Crashing hard onto the floor.
Taken to the air and completely wiping out.
Boom! Elbow throw, saying not today.
Spine buster!
He can do it here.
Shoulder up and the referee ends the count.
He's still in this.
And JBL evades that.
He's starting to struggle here.
Sheamus came looking for a fight, and this is clearly just what happens when he finds a fight.
He deflects it right back.
And we've seen how this rivalry has escalated to the point that no one involved cares about the collateral damage they've caused.
Hell, Michael, they don't even care about their own well-being. They just want to destroy and embarrass the other, no matter the price or consequences.
And that is what makes this whole situation so scary.
Sheamus looking for a fight no matter how it comes his way.
Look at the power of the wrestling god, JBL.
Saw that coming.
Running STO plants him.
Nicely done.
Boom, right across the small back. From the top. Oh, huge miss there. Return fire on the... Celtic Warrior.
He's looking to do whatever it takes to survive.
Hit and drop. I've been witnessing that.
And Sheamus really having the fight brought to him there.
This is where endurance becomes so important in the late stages of the match.
Setting them up for the beats. Of the Baron.
Nowhere to go.
Just brutal. Oof.
I don't know if this is a good idea. This is going to take more strength than he has left.
A lift up. Whoa.
Hey, Philly, you ready?
Uh-oh.
Just like that, Bradshaw finds a counter.
Right.
Fallaway slam.
There he goes, right into the corner.
Top of that turnbuckle is not where you want to be.
Reversal. What a counter. Clothesline.
He right to the midsection. Setting them up for the Falcon Arrow. Yet imagine we're hitting the late stages of this matchup. Who's going to dig deeper at this point?
We might just take that extra push, that extra inch further to create the difference.
Unleashing a barrage on their opponent.
Delivers a leg drop.
The Celtic Warrior letting some of that constant rage and frustration out.
I think we know what's coming next.
Nothing like a feisty Sheamus inciting the fans in attendance.
Oh,
clothesline.
So effective.
Clothesline from hell.
Sheamus is in crisis mode.
Makes the cover.
He stays alive. He stays alive.
Sheamus is still alive. The Celtic Warrior loves a fight and does not want this one.
Up high.
Now it's a test of will.
Gets him with the counter. What a knockout punch!
Oh, man. What energy in the arena tonight.
What now?
Stop right there. Got it.
Taking this to the floor.
Dribbling the opponent's head like a basketball.
He catches JBL with a counter. And he gets delivered back into the ring.
Well, the Celtic Warrior wants a fight. And one more.
Close line for power from JBL.
Will that clinch things for JBL?
Another peek at some of the more memorable parts of the match.
Here is your winner, John Bradshaw Layfield, JBL.
A statement victory by this guy tonight.
Distracting Sheamus.
Oh my gosh, where's the violin?
The following contest is scheduled for 1-4 and is for the WWE Championship.
The title collector is here.
WWE superstars have held two championships simultaneously, and this man now joins their ranks.
Yeah, it's an honor no matter how long you hold both titles, but the reality is most other champions lose at least one title before long.
This man is determined to be the exception rather than the rule.
Talk about standing at the top of the mountain. This guy is at the peak of Mount Everest.
Indeed, it is going to take a monumental effort to take either one of this guy's titles.
Time world champion and a royal.
day, one of the toughest fighters in WWE.
Scottish Warrior has earned every bit of respect he is given. He is transformed from the Chosen One to a real-life, fire-breathing dragon.
Yeah, the WWE is the Scottish Warrior's battleground, and he will go face-to-face with absolutely anyone.
Introducing the challenger from Ayr, Scotland, weighing in at 254 pounds, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre. And his opponent from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds, he is the WWE Champion, the Viper, Randy Orton.
You can see it in the eyes of each individual. Only razor sharp focus when this much is on the line.
I'm sure plenty of people remember Drew McIntyre's departure from WWE, but his return ended up being the more momentous occasion.
No question there. McIntyre came back more experienced, more dominant, and frankly, bigger than anyone could have ever imagined.
And ever since that return, it seems like Drew has only gotten more impressive inside the ring.
And he has taken on Randy Orton, who has become, dare I say it, a kinder, gentler Viper?
You may not dare. Orton isn't a kinder Viper, just a smarter one. He learned to adapt and improve with each year, and it's only made him more potent as a superstar.
Handling his opponent is Drew McIntyre.
I've seen Saxon thrown out of a few local bars like that before.
Please don't remind me, Corey.
Corey, McIntyre and Orton are longtime rivals. They both traded wins and even the WWE Championship. What do you think the key is for either man to gain a true advantage here?
Well, they both obviously can't forget their history, Cole, but they also can't be stuck in the past, which is where I think McIntyre has the advantage over Orton. McIntyre has an uncanny ability to soldier on and focus on the road ahead, where Orton can get tripped up trying to exact revenge.
Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
Orton gets the better there. Run out of ringside and back to the mat.
The throw was definitely not thinking about finesse with that one. Was only thinking about dominance.
Back and forth from these competitors.
And we know for a fact that this is just not some casual matchup. Guys, this rivalry has seemingly reached critical mass.
Well, I'd actually say it could be worse, but it's definitely not great as it is.
The pin attempt for the championship. The challenger's able to kick out.
Wow.
Can he take advantage?
Saw that one coming. Took advantage.
Bang it back with their own kick.
Kick to the gut.
Ooh, brutal form.
Just one step ahead.
vicious right forearm.
And he was ready for it.
Viper escapes harm.
Power slam. Challenger's a little worse for wear now.
Reverses and looks to capitalize.
He must have seen that coming.
And both athletes showing that they have each other's number.
McIntyre and Orton know this is all about so much more than winning now. This is about pride. This is about solidifying supremacy. And neither man will stop until they achieve that goal.
We might be here for a long time.
Oh, Randy Orton, the apex predator.
A Viper looking unstoppable.
Vintage Orton.
Coming and answers with the clothesline.
Not the position you want to be in right now.
Face first. He's treading all over their opponent.
And he's able to reverse.
Looks under his go behind. German suplex turns the tides.
He's going for it all. He's begging him to get up so he can put him back down.
Up high.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Plucked out of the air.
Scoop slam sets things up.
And he throws the opposition back into the ring.
He's gotta know he's in harm's way here.
Let's go, kiss.
McIntyre giving it right to Orton.
McIntyre.
Before the horse. The champ kicked out and has no intentions on losing that title anytime soon.
McIntyre won't lose focus, though. He's got to remain as sharp as he was a few moments ago. Listen to this place.
Here's another look.
Here is your winner and the new WWE champion, the Scottish Warrior, Drew McIntyre.
An exciting match that concludes with a title changing hand.
Honestly, Michael, there is no way I can think to describe this other than absolute goosebumps.
Then imagine how the new champ must feel, Byron.
for the WWE Championship.
You think you know me?
Has come back hungrier and tougher than ever.
Introducing the challenger from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, weighing in at 249 pounds, Edge! And his opponent from Atlanta, Georgia, weighing in at 220 pounds, he is the WWE Champion, the
in this arena is palpable.
These competitors know exactly what's on the line. And Cody Rhodes will kick things off. Really one of the more remarkable careers in the history of our business, wouldn't you say?
He likes to say,
looking for an early pin.
It's going to take more than that to keep him down.
Tried to make short work of things here.
Clothesline!
Well, that'll leave a mark.
He has an answer for Rhodes.
Flip.
It might not be flip.
flashy, but sometimes you just gotta toss another person and make a statement.
Suplex!
Corey, what kind of preparation should an opponent do before getting in the ring with Edge?
Well, there's plenty of tape you can study when it comes to Edge, so you need to start there. Learn his timing, plan some counters to his favorite attacks. The possibilities are endless. That's why you always do your homework if you can.
To the gut.
Ooh, brutal forearm.
He takes control.
Showing some extra scouting, knowing how to answer a counter with a counter of your own.
Champ taking the worst end of the exchange.
Big blow could be felt throughout the arena. Just won't give up.
An agile escape.
Oh, what a flying heel kick.
A steady charge here from Edge.
Edge is holding nothing back.
Ooh, what a punch.
That's how you stop your opponent.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my gosh, what impact. Over and over. So much aggression.
Looking at the unpredictable, unhinged side of Edge coming out.
Edge on the receiving end. Time now to get his energy up and claw back into the fight.
Vertebraker!
Cover! Two! Titleback stays alive.
This is going to come down to who wants it more.
Able to get the advantage here.
Championship dreams.
Let's see if that kick out was a spark or is it the challenger's last gasp.
Looks like Cody is going to have to readjust, maybe strategize here. He thought that was it, but somehow it wasn't.
Execution!
Catches the kick.
Every maneuver being returned with counter fire.
Lining it up. Gonna cut him in half.
With a spear! The champ's eyes look glazed over.
Two! Oh my, that was close!
The title still hanging in the balance.
Resilience of a champion on display.
And Edge thought he had this sewn up. He went with what brought him success, but it didn't provide results.
This deep into a match is where trouble rises, where injuries may occur. You gotta think long term and consider your future fights.
And I guarantee you that throwing in the towel is the furthest thing these superstars are thinking about.
Boom!
Look out!
Full wide overhead kick!
Cody's cut open. But I think he's in his element, guys.
And Cody Rhodes is failing to offer any resistance here.
Yeah, Cody's having trouble fighting back.
Getting up, but doesn't have a clue what's coming at him.
Incredible spear!
is an Extreme Rules match. Making his way to the ring from the Isle of Samoa, weighing in at 425 pounds, Rikishi.
He's held the Intercontinental Championship, multiple tag team titles.
And Kishi may be the best dancer in WWE history. Besides you, Cole.
Thanks, Corey. I won a number of dance contests.
Hey, did you guys know I used to watch Rikishi tapes to get ready for my age?
Anyhow, Corey, what do you think about Rikishi and his career?
I think Rikishi is one of the most fun-loving yet dominant WWE superstars we have ever seen. Deceptively agile, hard-hitting, and no one has more fun than the big man.
What about me?
Saxton, get off the desk. This is not permission for you to twerk.
Ah, I'm raising the roof, Corey. Watch me.
Roman Reigns, the leader of the Bloodline, has arrived.
And his opponent, representing the Bloodline, from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, the WWE Champion, Roman Reigns.
When you see a superstar like Roman Reigns, you see a man who seems practically untouchable.
Exactly, Saxton. Like a god. An immortal.
Man, he's achieved things that most only dream of. Just piles of championships.
Made the long climb up the mountain and shoved everybody else off of it.
In an Extreme Rules match, it's hard to predict what will happen, but they're looking to catch him off guard.
One.
In an ear fall.
For a match that's only just begun, that was a close count.
Elbow, elbow, and elbow barrage.
Elbows on the mark.
Just punched him right in the mouth. Relentless.
Enough already.
Tagging this outside.
This could be good.
He leaves the ring, and there's no countouts in this one. That hit connects from Roman Reigns.
Oh, that is going to leave a mark.
Steel stairs to the face. Face first off the knee. Things now not going well for Rikishi.
Yeah, Rikishi's on the wrong side of every exchange.
And now thrown back into the ring.
Rikishi able to dodge that.
Back suplex.
In a no disqualification match, you never want to be the superstar on the wrong end of a chair or a kendo stick or whatever else might be hiding under the ring. You want to be the one inflicting that punishment because that's how you control the pace and the match as a whole.
He's got him here. He's got him up.
And oh!
And this one might be headed ringside. Oh, colliding with a barricade. He's taking this to the floor now. Getting carried around. Bad spot to be in.
Oh, no, 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 no. The powerbomb's not meant to be pretty, but oh man, does it get the job done.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they don't want to be taking any more of those.
And that was a well-executed attack.
And each of these lethal maneuvers
each of these attacks.
Oh, he fights Rikishi back.
Both superstars showing great awareness of their opponent's repertoire.
And he slides him back to the mat.
Change something up with the pin technique.
He avoids the damage.
Far off with an elbow.
Ooh, bullseye. Escapes in a nick of time. Launch out to the outside.
Just a devil-may-care attitude on full display.
Going for broke, and it pays off.
The steps connect.
That hurt me just watching.
The big dog's unleashed.
Roman seems tapped into his endless reserve of strength.
Oh, the reversal by Rikishi.
And that might be the momentum swing Rikishi needed.
Could be the exact U-turn Rikishi needed in this match.
That's his strategy. Oh, he retaliates.
Power slam.
Oh, this, what a headbutt. No telling what's underneath the ring tonight.
He's got a kendo stick, a weapon we've seen used to great effect time and time again. Oof. Evades the attack.
Saving us from having to sit through that.
Wow, Reigns nailed it.
The end is looming now. Might want to walk it off or shake it off or do whatever he needs to do to get his head in the game here. I don't care who you are. You can't take consecutive attacks like that without it affecting you. Straight impact down the throat. And now gets tossed into the ring. Big. Finds its mark.
Reigns able to sidestep.
Close line.
Snapmare takeover. Followed by.
He saw that one coming. Headbutt to the back of the neck.
Oh, disabling the leg with that.
Ow, right in the kisser. Didn't see it coming. Oh, running STO plants him.
Nicely done.
He may be in a bad way here.
Showing a lot of fortitude in this Extreme Rules match for sure. But not sure how much more tenable it could be. Any one of these attacks could cause irreparable damage, but I don't think you can come back from this many.
A earth-shaking power slam. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here. Look at this. Now Rikishi has the firm upper hand.
You're not going to see Rikishi show any remorse.
Gotta wonder what he's thinking about when he sets it up here.
attempt to press on the advantage.
Reigns isn't allowing that.
Reigns delivers a Superman punch. Knocked out. Can Rikishi come back from that?
With a win like this, things have got to taste a little bittersweet right about now.
Actually, Saxton, I imagine the win tastes a lot more like pennies.
The following contest is an Extreme Rules match and is for the SmackDown Women's Championship.
She is a woman who is here to take control.
Like these matches against the best competition WWE has to offer. Her first women's championship reign came at the expense of Charlotte.
I don't know how you can't be nervous when you are prepared for the match of your life against the greatest generational talent in women's division history.
Here comes the queen, Charlotte Flair.
A woman who has truly done it all. WWE. Well, Corey, I'm sure you would agree that no one makes quite an entrance like Charlotte Flair.
I completely agree, Saxton, because every time she's in the ring, it is a spectacle to behold.
Charlotte Flair competed in the first women's match to main event WrestleMania and takes pride in always controlling the situation around her.
There is no one better in the big moment than Charlotte Flair.
As physically dominant as any superstar we have ever seen.
Charlotte is always happy to send a message inside the ropes.
And each step furthers her legacy.
Introducing the challenger from San Jose, California, Bayley. And her opponent from the Queen City, she is the SmackDown Women's Champion, Charlotte Flair.
A charged atmosphere as we get set for a SmackDown Women's title match. Everyone who holds the SmackDown Women's title has managed to make it their own and bring a special something to their reign.
That's right. This title is an opportunity to change the perception of being a champion. Someone will get that chance tonight.
Oh, that hurt. Well scattered reversal there.
Ooh.
Uh-oh, this is just vicious, vicious arm stomp. That is just insulting.
Drops the knee. And now she's climbing to the top turnbuckle. Here we go.
What? Big time risk pays off.
The daredevil in you comes out when you take risks like that.
Charlotte a step ahead there.
Extreme Rules has to be one of the most difficult matches for a superstar to prepare for.
Yeah, I don't know if you can ever enter an Extreme Rules match even close to fully prepared. There's no telling what twisted things that have been boiling in your competition's mind.
Well, this is a warning to grab our stuff and go.
Keep it in the ring, please. Saxton's a very fragile boy.
Drop.
Eat defeat.
Nice running crossbody.
There are plenty of ways battling in this area could end in serious harm.
All right, that's it.
Got the front face lock applied. Nice suplex. The challenger's looking shaken. Top block.
That was just wrong. You should be a better person than that.
Arms trapped.
Endless knee strikes.
What a reversal by Bayley. She's got a lot of heart and a lot. Guys, I cannot figure out how she's going to break this hold. Oh, but she reverses the pressure. Incredible move. And gets tossed back into the mat. Challenger is not in a great place. Oh, and here comes Bayley. And look at Bayley go. Picking up the pace. This is where she's at her best. Incredible momentum shift here. And the WWE fans are behind Bayley. There it is. Bayley up, Bayley. And shoulders are down. Two. Manages to escape before the three count.
No celebrations yet.
She had it scouted.
Quick exchange, reversing the reversal.
Set up in the corner of the ring. Heading up top.
High risk. Here we go. That is wild.
Goes into the pin. Two. The champ kicks out at 2.5.
Almost unbelievable that she kicked out at all.
Got the underhook.
Nice. Now a pin for the championship.
Oh, a kick out, a kick out, a kick out.
Somebody pinched me. I got to be dreaming. There's no way she's still in this match.
Oh, a dragon screw ankle breaker.
Targeting the ankle. How did Bayley and Charlotte continue to get up?
Adrenaline? Desire?
I mean, it's all you can call it. Just whipped into the table.
She steers clear of that one. These two trading counters, an absolute masterclass.
She did. Huge toss.
Facing off at the top of the ramp.
I don't know what's going to happen, but it's going to hurt.
Knee drop. And there's Bayley with more offense.
I think Bayley's forming a plan to end this conflict soon.
That's disrespectful.
Escape just in time.
There are a lot of ways this can go sideways. Everything on that stage looks like it hurts.
The showstopper.
Bayley's got her hooked.
Oh, and Bayley with a suplex.
Oh, this is a pretty dangerous place to fight. Screens, exposed metal, ledges, so much could go wrong very quickly.
Bayley did her homework there.
These superstars are showing no concern for their own well-being. All that matters to them right now is doing as much damage to one another as possible.
Arena can't contain them, and if history's any indication, nothing good's about to happen up there either.
Great awareness as he proves to be too quick.
Going counter for counter. Now, can it be capitalized on?
Got the leg.
Well placed elbow to the leg.
Intensity and anger boiling over, all coming to a head up on the stage.
As we can only see, it's only getting worse by the second, Michael.
Wow, what a strike to the back. Yeah. Matt slam
with some attitude.
This fight has made its way to the entranceway.
Oh, man, so many things can go wrong now.
Bayley is really displaying aggression here.
The Queen's perseverance being tested here.
What a raucous crowd here tonight.
The front face lock applied.
Nice suplex. And the possibility for serious injury just went way up.
These superstars are starting to get very imaginative right now. You have to think someone's looking at that stage and getting some dark thoughts.
Oh, sit up, powerbomb.
Plenty of ways to get creative up on the entrance area.
Also, plenty of ways to get yourself seriously hurt.
Lock toe takedown. Beautiful transition to the STF camel clutch.
Submission locked in. Nowhere to go. Nowhere to go. Is she going to tap out?
How much? Look at this. She continues to fight. She won't be denied.
Nice takedown.
There are a lot of ways this can go sideways. Everything on that stage looks like it hurts.
Drop kick to the back. And Bayley connected nicely there.
Out of that.
She will wisely return to the ring now.
What's she looking for under the ring?
A complete lack of respect from Bayley to the ding-dong across from her.
Sledgehammer has emboldened her.
Oh, disturbing impact.
Weapon in hand, just toying with her now.
Oh, the sledgehammer connects. That'll scramble your insides.
Clearly waiting for that.
We're at a vital stage in this matchup, and this audience is fully aware of it.
Yeah, they know another turning point can come at any second, and that can be the instant that ends it all.
Bayley is now under pressure. Charlotte's providing Bayley with the punishing reminder who's in charge here.
An elusive Bayley there.
Flawless takedown. No count out as she takes this fight to the floor. Bang! Getting back into the ring. And no countouts means she has the whole outside to play with.
Good defense. Nasty chop delivered by Charlotte. Followed by natural selection. A championship level move.
The queen looking to finish things off. Here's the figure four.
To the figure eight.
Figure eight win via submission.
Charlotte defends the title again.
We've got some highlights from the last one queued up. Here we go.
Here's your winner, and still the SmackDown Women's Champion, Charlotte Flair!
Charlotte Flair standing tall, knowing that she did what she said she was going to do.